Why does Delhi have so many earthquakes? Is there someone up there who just shakes up Delhi like it's a game of boggle whenever they're bored? Because the fact is, some of the world's most destructive earthquakes in history are in northern India, in Delhi and its surroundings. In 1720, there was a massive earthquake in Delhi. And then in 1803, and in this one, the Qutub Minar lost two of its top stories. In 1905, which damaged the Kangra Fort. In 1923, which completely destroyed the temple of Yamunotri. Then there were earthquakes in 1842, 1956, 1960. So once again, why does Delhi have so many earthquakes? Well, there's a reason, a historical reason for it. You see, 140 million years ago, India, Australia, Antarctica, and South America were like one supercontinent family called Gondwana. Then Gondwana broke up and India and Madagascar became a separate piece of land, also called island, and started drifting northwards. 100 million years ago, India and Madagascar broke off too, and India drifted off on its journey alone. At that time, India was off the coast of present-day Australia. Between India and Asia was the Tethys Sea. Say hello. 80 million years ago, India was roughly 6,400 kilometers far from Asia, but was drifting up the Tethys Sea at about 20 centimeters each year. Between 40 and 50 million years ago, India and Eurasia collided. That was when India became a part of Asia, and the collision birthed the giant Himalayas. Since then, the Himalayas are growing up so fast, clothes shopping is becoming difficult. So India continues to push into Asia 5 centimeters each year. And this is pushing parts of northern Asia eastwards into the Pacific Ocean. So these plates, tectonic forces that keep pushing up, build tremendous pressure within the Earth's crust, which releases itself along the fault lines, which lie near Delhi. That is why some of the world's most destructive earthquakes in history are in northern India, Delhi and its surroundings. And more are coming.